Hello, sports fans. With another week in the books and another to prepare for, Thrive Fantasy Sports is your go-to one-stop shop for all your sports betting needs. Up to $75,000 in prizes each and every week. When you use the promo code SPORTSCHOICE, they'll match your first instant deposit up to $50 with a minimum of $20 deposit for the first-time use of the app. What are you waiting for? Come prop up with us.
Hello, sports fan. This is Stephen Hill for Sports Choice Plus. I'm bringing you a very special breakdown. I'm going to be covering the NFL Top 10 headed into Week 16. Before I get right into that, smash the subscribe button. Make sure you hit it to make sure you're getting all the updates each and every time we have breakdowns here at Sports Choice Plus. Without further ado, we're going to get right into the action. This NFL season has given us one gem after another. We saw a lot of movement up and down the power rankings, and you're seeing a lot of teams closing out the season and trying to get playoff spots. So this is the top 10 going into week 16. Looking at number 10, you're looking at the Pittsburgh Steelers. We all saw them get embarrassed on Monday Night Football. We all saw the Cincinnati Bengals just like look like they wanted it more. Big Ben and company are in trouble. When you're looking at the ability to run the football, it's non-existent with Pittsburgh. When you're looking at them having to manufacture offense in different ways, yes, they have little outbursts when they can throw the football extremely well, but you also have to look at the other side of that coin. They also have negative times when they're dropping passes wide open, fumbling the ball, and then the Achilles heel at this point is becoming injuries on the defensive side of the ball. They've lost a number of starters on defense, so that makes it hard when you get into those games where it's close, where guys would normally step up and make plays, the inexperience of their backups are starting to show. Pittsburgh overall, to start the year, they got a considerably easier schedule, and now you're seeing that they're having to play a couple of tougher teams, and they're struggling quite a bit. So they're at number 10. They still have a couple of weeks to fix this if they want to be an actual Super Bowl contender. As of right now, they're at number 10 on the fringe of being outside of the power rankings. Coming in at number 9. You're looking at the team that's on my head, Indianapolis Colts. The Indianapolis Colts played a terrific game against the Texans. They held their stand for the last defensive stop, and they did everything they needed to do to get the victory. Sometimes it's not going to be cute wins or pretty wins. Sometimes you got to get down and you got to scrap with those NFL teams and get the job done. The ability to stop the Texans basically helped them move up in the power rankings as far as staying in the power rankings because they have so many different things that they do well. From running the football, defensively, they're attacking. They do a pretty good job of getting turnovers. They also do a pretty good job of potentially scoring or putting that offense in a position where they can score after a turnover has happened. You're looking just overall at what this team is. I think it's a blue-collar team. I think they're hardworking. You got a pretty good mix of veterans in there. But the ability for the coaching staff to put these guys in positions where they don't have to do what's outside their role is tremendous. I like Indy. I like where they're headed. I like their physicality at this point. And when they're running the football, it's hard for anybody to stay in front of them because their offensive line is filled with road raiders. And I'm telling you, they're nasty. They're getting out and they're pancaking people. You can see it on the film. You can see it on the replays. You can see it on a little bit of everything. But the Colts are pretty good right now. Coming in at number 9. Coming in at number 8. Coach Flores deserves nods for Coach of the Year, like so many other coaches in the NFL this year that have been doing a pretty good job. The Miami Dolphins come in. Being able to beat Bill Belichick, I know it's not the same Patriots team as it was in the old, but being able to consistently give those kind of efforts each and every week, week in and week out, these guys are playing at a fantastic level. You saw Tua not only use his arm, but you saw him use his legs as well. Being able to get down, score a couple of touchdowns, being able to throw the ball as well. The Miami Dolphins are starting to shape up into playoff contenders. And when you see just how well the offense has improved, how well the defense has improved, how well special teams has improved, it's so many different things. And it's little things here and there that have been tweaked. The discipline, it's a number of things that help Miami to the point where now they're on the doorstep of making the playoffs. You look at them and their contention with the Patriots over the last couple of years. Yeah, they were able to win one game here or there, but their consistent body of work throughout the season and even the way that they lost to the Kansas City Chiefs, it spoke volumes. They stayed in the game. They continued to fight. It's just so many different things that this team is doing well that's why they're in the power rankings, and I think they're going to go far with this coaching staff. You know, you got a lot of good playmakers on that team, so I like the nucleus of this team, and they're going to consistently keep moving up. Coming in number seven, the Saints. The Saints made the game close against the Chiefs, and they played a pretty good brand of football. I know that losing one of your best defensive players with Cameron Jordan late in that football game could have had an adverse effect on how close this game was, as far as they potentially could have made a couple of plays later and even won the game. But you're looking at the Saints right now, and you're saying, can Drew Brees get this offense on track? I know that Drew Brees came back. He was playing a little rusty, if you will. But late in that game, he started catching fire. Late in that football game, he started making the passes and throws that we know Drew Brees can make. And I think that because Drew Brees is a high-volume thrower, he needs a couple of throws to get his arm ready. He needs a couple of throws. He needs to see a couple of completions, and then he starts to get on track. I don't have any doubt that Sean Payton can't get this team back on track offensively with the coaching staff that they have, especially Sean Payton, the ability to call up plays, the ability to put the schemes in place. I have faith that Sean Payton can do that. I think New Orleans is going to get right back on track this week. The loss to the Chiefs just means they have two losses in a row, one to the Eagles and one to the Chiefs. But don't be worried, Saints fans. I think that you guys are still in a pretty good spot, considering the Packers are just the team above you. But you just think, you know, Taysom Hill's done a pretty good job of keeping the fort together while Drew Brees was gone. To the fact of he only lost one game against the Eagles, and that's pretty good. That's pretty good considering what he had to do, and he was thrown into the fire, basically. So that's why the Saints are at number seven. Coming in at number six, the Seattle Seahawks. They've started to see a couple of injuries here and there. Hopefully, knock on wood, DK Metcalf is okay. But these guys are playing with tremendous heart. You saw that game against the Washington football team, how Russ was just magical. He got his team in position to get those third downs converted to first downs. He got his team in position to make sure when they did take a loss, it wasn't a maximum loss. He held the ball down, took the sack when he needs to, and he put his team in great position to score. When you're looking at the hard work ethic of a lot of these guys on the Seahawks, the defense is starting to play a little bit better. And now, at this point, because it's almost playoff time, you're starting to see a lot of these guys make big plays. And one thing I want to look at, Russ, when he has the ability to see and read the defense, it makes a big difference. He used the aggressiveness of Washington against them, and that helped them win the football team. That's just some of the smart quarterbacking plays that Russell Wilson can make, and that's why he's one of the top NFL quarterbacks in the NFL. As long as Russ is healthy, this team has a fighting shot, and with that offense that they have a fighting shot as well. You want to see them do a little bit more as far as defensively to hold the scores down each and every week, but I think that they're doing it right now. So there's no complaints from me. That's why they're at number six. I think they're pretty good, and especially with the Rams loss, that doesn't really bode well for the Rams, but the Seahawks are looking good right now. Coming in at number five, the Cleveland Browns. They had a magnificent win against the New York Giants. All you had to do was win the game, and they did it. Baker Mayfield was a couple of yards shy of 300 yards, played in command most of the football game. The Browns look pretty good. Nick Chubb and company are pretty good. They got a couple of Pro Bowlers off that team that were just selected. So all these things are boding well. I like what Stefanski is doing with the offense. He's being creative each and every week. He's not giving Baker Mayfield a lot of space to fail. And as a quarterback coach slash offensive coordinator slash head coach, he's doing what he needs to do. He's taking responsibilities before things get out of hand. He's taking over the play calling and helping assist in that department. And that's showing you, early in the season when they were struggling, he took up and he said, look, we're not going to fail. This is what we're going to do. That's why the Cleveland Browns and the Dog Pound are having success. Execution, attention to detail. Also, Myles Garrett is playing out of his mind right now. Even when he's not getting to the actual quarterback, his blitzing ability, being double team, being triple team, he's starting to show you why he was the number one overall draft pick, and those dividends are paying out to the Cleveland Browns right now. Coming in at number four, the Tennessee Titans. Their ability to run the football is leading them into the playoff picture. The ability not only for them to come out fast, but to score points big time. You saw how they put those points up on the Lions and exactly what they were able to do. With no real defense against the Titans, they were able to do what they do best. When you look at Derrick Henry, if he gets going, that opens up the offense for the entirety of these wide receivers, the entirety of the tight end department. The offensive line is still playing pretty good. Ryan Tannehill is making big throws. He's also using his legs. He's underrated as a runner. When he gets the space, he'll go ahead and score those touchdowns. He'll go ahead and extend those first downs. And I think that's a big part of the Tennessee offense. And I like where they're going right now. So that's why the Titans are at number four right now. And they're playing pretty well. Coming in number three, you got the Green Bay Packers. Yes, they won against the Panthers. It was not a pretty victory for Aaron Rodgers and company. Matter of fact, I wanted to see Aaron Rodgers do more in that football game. Because they didn't have the best showing, it's hard for me to really put more stock into them as than I see right now. There's no complaints. They are the number one seed in the NFC right now, and they are playing at a pretty good level. I just want to see right now Aaron Rodgers polish off some throws. I want to see him finish games strong, and I want to see Devontae Adams, of course, score touchdowns, but they are pretty good. They beat a Carolina Panthers team that is down right now, and that's why they're at number three at 11-3. Coming in at number two, the Buffalo Bills, just moving up the power rankings each and every week, just taking care of their business each and every week. We saw them destroy the Denver Broncos. They were not playing any games. Stephon Diggs, it's time for us to have that conversation, because Stephon Diggs was deemed as a troublemaker in Minnesota. He was deemed as a problem. He was deemed as a cancer in Minnesota. So we have to start looking and saying, Stephon Diggs in Buffalo, he's not demanding the ball. He's not creating any problems. He's fitting in with his teammates. Was the issue really Stephon Diggs in Minnesota? Or was it Kirk Cousins? Being able to be a diva wide receiver, that's what a lot of people get labeled in the NFL when they're a wide receiver that talks up. But in this case, I don't think it's that. I think Stephon Diggs just wanted a chance to get those 50-50 balls. He wanted a chance to make plays. And now that Josh Allen has given him that opportunity, he's doing everything. He's blocking. He's catching. He's doing whatever is asked of him. You look at the defense. Defense is flying flat out. Fastest NFL defense in the NFL, I believe. When you're looking at the cornerback position, they're loaded. When you look at the defensive line position, they're loaded. The linebackers are flying off the shelves. They're doing everything Coach McDermott is asking them to. Josh Allen's growth. He has jumped tremendously in his poise, his pocket awareness, his ability to throw the football away when he's in trouble, the ability to extend the play and get the ball deep downfield. With Cole Beasley and company there, Stephon Diggs there, they're doing everything asked of them. That's why they're at number two. They're dominating teams that they're supposed to. They beat the Pittsburgh Steelers a couple weeks ago, and they're slowly ascending to the top team in the NFL. Going into the playoffs, you may want to start looking at putting your money, Bills Mafia, on the Buffalo Bills. I have no reason to believe they'll have any setbacks. I have no reason to believe they're going to stumble, and they're playing like champions right now. Coming in at number one, the Kansas City Chiefs. These guys put out, an excellent effort against the New Orleans Saints, and seeing exactly how Patrick Mahomes and company are getting it done. One thing I do want to focus on is Tyrann Mathieu. We talk about the offense so much, but when you've got players like Tyrann Mathieu on the defense and Jones at the defensive tackle position, they have so many different veterans who are making big plays week after week, and they don't get mentioned as much because they're not offensively. Yes, we know about Travis Kelce, and I told you guys, he is going to continuously get his. You can't double team Hill, and you can't double team Travis Kelce every single play and expect nobody else to be open. When you're looking at the defensive side of the ball, they are literally humming. They're getting to the plays. It was so many different plays against the Saints that I saw Tyrann Mathieu's hands on the catch. I saw so many different players batting balls down from Drew Brees, or dislodging the ball from the ball carrier or the wide receiver. It was excellent play all over the field. The Honey Badger is showing up, and it may not be stats that you can see, but his effort, his energy, his leadership, those are things that are boding well for this. At the running back position, they got to be a little concerned. They did lose Clyde Edwards. Le'Veon Bell took a couple of nasty hits towards the end of that football game. But they want to make sure that they're doing everything they can to continuously try to run the ball to stay balanced on offense. But the Kansas City Chiefs are my number one top 10 team this week. All you NFL fans, get in the comment section. Tell me what you think of the top 10 list. And as always, I thank you so very much for definitely checking us out this week. Make sure you're subscribed to the YouTube channel. And we'll see you next week. Thank you so very much. And we're looking forward to the playoffs coming up pretty soon. All right, good people.